Our next guest expects the Philippine bond market to be range-bound in the coming months after rallying by almost 400 basis points since October 2018. With us now for more is Andre Ibarra, the Senior Vice President and Deputy Treasurer for Security Bank. Good to have you with us, Andre. Welcome to the program. So you're expecting the bond market to possibly trade within a narrow range in the near term?
I expect the bond market to be range-bound in the near term. As you mentioned, to give just perspective on the bond market the past few months, the bond market has rallied actually very aggressively after inflation fell from the highs that we saw last October 2018. So from our high of 6.7, it's now a low at point of 0.8 at the most recent reading. So because of that, the bond market has rallied, and we've seen or we've heard actually the BSP Governor Diokno mentioned that the BSP is already on hold or will be on hold in the coming months or right. In 2019.
So what does that mean for your strategy then to lengthening the bank's funding profile going forward? I mean, you've raised over 6 billion pesos in offer of long-term negotiable certificates of deposit, the LTNCDs, last September, the second time that you've tapped the debt capital markets to raise funds this year.
Yes, that is true. Security Bank is always on the lookout for opportunities to tap these markets if we perceive that the opportunity is ripe for the bank to lengthen our debt profile. So we are on the lookout always for these opportunities, Kathy.
Are you seeing any opportunities in the offing? I mean, the 6 billion peso drawdown marks the first tranche of the bank's 20 billion pesos that had been approved by the Philippine Central Bank, so there's 14 billion more to go.
That is correct. We are, again, as I mentioned, we are constantly on the lookout for these opportunities, but nothing imminent as of the moment.
The Central Bank in September did draft a circular seeking to impose a moratorium on the offering of the LTNCDs, except those already approved this year. So what impact do you think will a moratorium have on the bank's access to long-term liabilities? Because the LTNCD is one of the few instruments where banks are able to term out the liabilities.
That is correct. So with this development, I think the banks will continue to tap this market until this window is closed. And other than the LTNCD, the banks also have other sources of funding that they can access, specifically the peso bond market, actually. So they can tap that as well.
That's true, but aren't LTNCDs much easier in fundraising than to a bond offering, as banks need to hire underwriters for the latter?
The process is actually very similar. So in terms of the work needed to execute these transactions, it's almost the same.
Would you be looking to tap the green bond market, green bond, a debt instrument earmarked for climate and environmental projects?
Yes, Security Bank is in the process of considering a green bond framework, and perhaps in the future we will have this green bond framework set up.
From what you know from that green bond framework, what sort of returns are you seeing in a green bond?
Actually, in terms of the yield, we don't see any significant pickup or discount on the yield. A green bond versus a regular normal bond. So as of now, there's no yield difference yet that we see versus a green bond compared to a normal bond.
So what's the incentive of getting into a green bond if there were no differences yet in the yield differentials?
I think some offshore investors now have dedicated funds that really invest in these green assets. So that will be the incentive for the banks and, again, for the investor community. Because a lot of funds are now very aware of this green bond framework. So a lot of the asset managers and funds are have dedicated funds for these kinds of assets.
In fact, a lot of money is going into the green bond market. So what sort of projects would you be looking at? The Securities and Exchange Commission previously identified projects such as renewable energy, pollution prevention, clean transportation, and climate change adaptation. Which ones?
I think for us, it's more of the renewable energy sector. That's one thing that our bank looks at very closely.
And final point, I know that you're seeing the peso weaken from current levels, but how much weaker by the end of the year? And what about for next year? And what's going to be the driver for that?
I think the dollar, the peso will depreciate slightly from where we see it right now, possibly around the 51.50 level due to the expected deterioration of the current account as the government spends on infrastructure. So with that, we expect the peso to weaken at around 51.50, possibly year end, and around 52 level next year.
All right. Well, keep tabs of that. Thank you so much for joining us, Andre Ibarra of Security Bank in Rockwell.